Tonight, a $1,000 iPad ripoff.
Scammers walk into a Casselberry salon wearing Best Buy uniforms and trick the victims into buying fake iPads and a television. Stephanie Culp has a story you'll see only on WESH 2. And Stephanie, the con artist's pitch and packaging made this scam quite believable.
Yeah, that's right, Martha. The scammers walked into this hair and nail salon here in Casselberry selling these iPads. You can see it looks pretty real, even has the Apple emblem there on the back. But when you take it out of the packaging, you can see it's nothing but a brick underneath. Zizi Garcia wanted to surprise her husband, Alvin, with a new iPad. So when three men and one woman came into her Casselberry hair and nail salon selling them, she thought it was the perfect opportunity. But $200 later, Zizi's husband got this.
When we unwrapped it, this is what we got.
They were scammed by four people who Alvin Garcia calls sophisticated con artists.
They literally had blue Best Buy shirt with their logo and name tags.
And the products they sold also had the Best Buy yellow price tag logo.
It looks legit, everything.
Zizi says she asked to see the actual iPad, and this is what they showed her. As you can see, it looks like a real iPad, feels like a real iPad. It's even the same size as an actual iPad. When she took it out of the packaging, you can see it's just a brick covered with a piece of paper.
I have a tile.
Alvin says a customer was duped as well, buying three iPads and this phony TV.
This is what she got. They had a new one in the truck, in the car they were driving. They showed her the new one out of the box, and ma'am, this is the one you get.
But Alvin says he and his wife learned their lesson.
No, never again. If people come in to sell something, I say get out.
Now, we reached out to Best Buy to see if they had heard about this scam, but we got no response from the company to our phone calls and emails. Now, Alvin says earlier this evening he had not filed a police report when I spoke to him earlier, but he has since spoken to police. He says originally he was actually worried that he would get in trouble for buying the counterfeit items. Reporting live tonight in Casselberry, Stephanie Culp, WESH 2 News.